The opinions expressed in the following program are not necessarily those of Eastlink TV, its sponsors, or partners.
Welcome to this episode of Secrets of Martial Arts. Today I have Sensei Chris Workman with me. Sensei Workman is a jiu-jitsu practitioner, a go-through practitioner, and what else did you say?
Brazilian jiu-jitsu, modern arnis, and kickboxing Muay Thai.
Now, that's a fairly extensive background. How long have you been in martial arts?
25 years. Originally started in Kokseolban in Elliott Lake, Ontario when I was 9 years old.
Which is a Korean art. We had our previous show as a Korean art.
Yes, I actually know Master Chuck. He was actually part of my upbringing. As a young man, I trained with him. I would come over for events in Sedbury and from Elliott Lake, and very familiar with all the Kokseolban family. So
right. Yeah. So what do you? So you've done these other arts. What do you teach then? Primarily, do you have one that you primarily teach,
I primarily teach the Shinbukan Jiu-Jitsu. That's my core. And then everything else is a complement to building off that. I also was teaching Goju Ryu Karate for full-time for 5 years, but then had switched gears into this just with the arrangements at the current gym. I had to select the program. And since I established this style under an international board back in 2014, I wanted to then keep growing the style and promoting the syllabus that was established within it. So.
Okay, so I had never heard of Shinbukan Jiu-Jitsu prior to talking with you about it. So yeah. Can you tell me a little bit about it? Jiu-Jitsu is quite old.
It is quite old, and it has many families, many bridges from the Daiti Ryu Aiki Jiu-Jitsu style. Sakaku Takeda Sensei had influenced many different practitioners, being Morihei Ishiba of Aikido, Jigoro Kano of Judo, who then Judo influenced the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu through Mitsumeda. And part of the training and the lineage in this was that there's different offshoots, like you had your Wara Jitsu, your Judo, and Shinbukan Jiu-Jitsu was born of both. There was a man who was the founder of Shinbukan who established himself in the Dominican Republic in the city of Santo Domingo in Santiago. And his name was Sensei Sakamoto Tamiyoshi Sensei.
Okay.
So. His adopted son, Takeyoshi, is my sensei and is the inherited soke of Shinbukan. Very big in the islands, and that's where it was established. 2013, they celebrated 50 years of Shinbukan karate and multiple styles. So my mandate has been to establish Shinbukan and bring in multiple styles to help better enhance cross-training within the martial arts, keep the tradition alive, but also adapt to modern times.
So it's pays homage and keeps the traditional values, but allows a modern slant to it, or is that how
yes,
it works?
Yes, it does, because of the birth of mixed martial arts becoming so prominent since 1992.
Okay.
Bringing the martial arts into that modern fold is just evolution and adaptation. It's just a normal progression of things to also understand where it is in its current state, but then the tradition needs to also influence that.
Right.
It needs to show where the foundation was laid and still pay homage to where everything was born.
So if someone watching it, would it look like anything else that we might have seen, or is there similarities to old jiu-jitsu, or is there?
Yeah, you're gonna see combinations of old jiu-jitsu. You're gonna see similarities of different position controls within mixed martial arts. You're going to see a lot of similarities to Karate Bunkai, because the Karate Bunkai, the Renzoku Goshin Jitsu, is our foundation kata, which translates continuous self-defense technique. So, and that's all stemmed from the Goju Ryu Bunkai, which was a specialty of Sakamoto's and Takeyoshi's. Because of his background in Yuwara Jitsu and Judo,
right.
When he transitioned to Goju Karate, he was able to bring that self-defense and decipher the katas into a very elaborate bunkai. He was quite a bunkai specialist. So this has a lot of influence from that. And that's where we stay traditional.
So is it mostly joint locking, or I'm assuming with jiu-jitsu,
we specialize in takedowns and closing the distance. There's a lot of joint locking, strangulation, submissions, pins. So it's very well rounded.
Okay, interesting. And strikes, are there strikes involved?
Of course, you should always know how to strike.
Oh, that's good. Well, after a short break, we're going to come back. We're going to actually see some of the techniques of the system. So thank you very much for coming.
Thank you, sir.
Water. We can't live without it. But in the world today, a lot of people can barely live with it. It's estimated that 1.8 billion people cook with, wash with, and drink contaminated water. 2.5 billion lack access to sanitation. In developing countries, people suffering from diseases caused by bad water, inadequate sanitation, and poor hygiene occupy half the hospital beds. Universal access to sanitation and clean water would save 2.5 million lives per year. Sounds expensive, right? But every dollar invested in water and sanitation returns on average more than $4 in increased productivity. Bottom line, we can't afford not to safeguard the world's water supply.
We're back with Secrets of the Martial Arts and Sensei Workman with his jiu-jitsu program. So, let's see. We're going to get an opportunity to see some jiu-jitsu.
All right. So, the Shinbukan jiu-jitsu is a modern-based Japanese jiu-jitsu art. Because there's a lot of takedowns involved in this syllabus, 48 in total, the first thing we need to learn to do is to fall safely to the ground. Without being able to fall to the ground, there's a higher risk of injury and a better chance that you won't be training on the next class if you hurt yourself. So, examples of hurting yourself from this technique in which a common person would fall to the ground, they would most commonly reach down. When you reach for the ground, this whole limb becomes compromised. From the wrist to your elbow to your shoulder, rotator cuff, you're going to be injured. So, first technique is to fall safely. Most of the time we're falling to the side in this style, so it's our core foundation. So, this is my senpai, Jeff. He's going to be helping demonstrate this technique. Everything starts from a fighting position. In Japanese, we still pay homage to our tradition, so we learn everything in Japanese. Everything is translated. So, kumite no kamai. From this position, there's a variety of technical things that happen. His feet have to move. Then he has to start positioning his upper body for the fall, which correlates with the arms. So from this one example, close ahead, sir. Sweep. He's going to fall, okay? Positions the leg down. So come back up. What we're going to do is going to take it one more rep, and we're going to sweep with the lead leg, okay? So in this example, you're gonna fall, you're gonna sweep with this lead leg. And notice as he sweeps, he positions his body more to the side and not on the flat of his back. That takes away any risk of upper shoulder injury and the back of the head. So as he sweeps, he's in a sideward position. Okay? Every position from a basic break fall translates into a technique. The Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu guys, when they're on the ground, their knees are up, their hands are through. These are grip positions in which his hands are our foundation right now. So, to come back up, the first technique to break this down into little pieces of a chain, the first piece of this chain is the sweep. Okay? So from here, we sweep. Okay? So Senpai, I'll have you come right here. Okay? Switch. Okay. Yeah. So the first element of this is the sweep. So I get in. I'm closing. I pull him in. Okay? The sweep itself would simulate that I was going to fall. But I don't fall. I just use the first element of this technique. From here, I unbalance him, and I sweep. Okay? So that's the first breakdown of this technique. The follow-through in which the technique is done will be putting the whole thing together, and I'll demonstrate this with Senpai. So from here, jab cross. One, two. Getting into a basic position here. Now, the same way as if after I swept my leg is extended, I go to the ground. This is a core foundation of our first takedown in the system. Teni Otoshi. Here, extend my leg, and I sit. Okay? High mount. He covers up, he's protected. But it shows how a basic technique like a breakfall, side sweeping breakfall, becomes a core movement in everything that you learn incrementally within the style. So, coming through, summarize here. Just do a side sweeping breakfall, switch your feet. Good. So sweep through. Position. Okay? Now, I'm just going to show a quick example because everything in this style is top to bottom. Okay, so I'll have you come over here, Senpai. On your back, back into position. Okay, now, if this was translated to a Newaza style, which is a ground grappling, okay, he stays in this position with me. He closes his guard. Okay, go low. Right here. This here simulates the hand position in which he would want to be underneath, cupping my armpit. Cup the armpit on the other side. Reach across, armpit knee.
You're a big guy.
Yep. And then this simulates gripping the pant leg. At which point, he would then do just a side break fall back and forth, and he'd be able to sweep me. Okay? So just to translate those positions. So, the mic, let go.
Yep. Yep.
So just to show the emphasis on where hands are positioned and how one basic technique translates into a multitude of techniques. So the next thing in the system is to close the distance. That's the core. There are a lot of good strikers. You got the Muay Thai, the kickboxers. This range is their playground. This is where they dominate. We want to not play in their world. We want to diffuse that by becoming extremely close. Because if I stay at the distance and he's a very good striker, I have to be a very good striker too. Which in the system, we do cover all aspects of striking, but to get through it. So we have two elements of closing the distance, or two steps. The first is a side position where you shuffle around. Okay. So, dealing with the jab cross again, most commonly patterned in all striking schools. From here, we want to close and become very safe and take away elements that can hurt and hit. So he's going to go nice and slow. He's going to throw that number one jab. I'm going to parry this down. At which point, I need to start advancing in. This hand, I have to be aware that it is coming. So he throws it out. I'm going to advance through, coming in with a cover block to protect. At which point, I trap
around his tricep. I grab inside, I set in a nice sumo stance, shikodachi stance, and I keep my face and my head close to his body. Even if he's very flexible and brings the knees up, that's okay, I can move. This shikodachi stance works at all eight directions, okay? Within the traditional eight gates, you can move around. Okay, if he's gonna kick my inside leg, I'm gonna move. Okay, so I come over here. So this is the first element of closing the distance. We rep this over and over and over to create muscle memory. Same thing with the break falls. The side sweeping over and over to create that muscle memory. So from here, we're gonna move on the second close. He's gonna throw the same combination, at which point here, I'm gonna push block and advance in through, putting my head onto his back, very safe place. Hand tucks under the floating rib, and I grip without using my thumbs. I grip inside, at which point we'll translate back to my side sweeping break fall. Tani Otoshi, okay? So the biggest aspect of this is being able to be safe in your practice and then to implement those safety techniques into your strategy. So into your martial arts. Okay? So again, quick summary. One, two. Okay. Always moving. Always moving. Never staying static. Again.
This is fascinating stuff, the way you get in, the way you're moving in, and you're closing the distance. We're going to take a short break, and when we come back, Sensei Work will be showing some more Shinbukan Jiu Jitsu. Thank you.
Seeds are important to me because all the world's food begins with a seed.
Seeds are important to me because our agricultural security depends on them.
Seeds are important to me because they hold enormous biodiversity going back thousands of years.
Future generations need these seeds.
Because our children need these seeds.
Maintaining diversity in seeds means we keep nutrition in our food.
Because as a father of three kids, I know how important good seeds are for providing healthy food for my family.
Because biodiversity tastes good.
Support farmers who save seeds.
Seeds are the key to food security.
Buy locally farmed food.
Know where your food comes from.
Everyone can be a seed saver.
Everyone.
Are you a seed saver?
Are you a seed saver?
Are you a seed saver?
I'm Amy Milan.
I'm Tim Kingsbury of Arcade Fire.
My name's Jim Cuddy.
I'm Bruce Coburn.
I'm Ian Thornley from Big Rack.
I'm Tim Baker.
I'm Leslie Feist, and I'm a seed saver.
I'm Sam Roberts. I'm a seed saver.
Be the voice for those who have no voice. Visit worldwildlife.org.
We're back with Sensei Workman in Shinbukan Jiu Jitsu, and we're going to see some more of the core system of Shinbukan Jiu Jitsu. So take it away.
Yes. Okay, so we've closed the distance, we've shown the basics of falling safely. The next thing you know is position control. Most commonly people, any altercation, someone may have a jacket or a t-shirt, or they have no shirt. So your position has to be dominant, it has to be safe, but it also has to open up a repertoire of what's happening. So, today Senpai is wearing a jacket, okay? I'm going to close in the distance. The biggest thing I need to understand is taking away his power hand. Most people are right hand dominant, okay? Not to take anything away from the lefties, but right hand dominant people are going to hit you with the most power in there. This is the first thing I need to remove, is this dominant hand. The next thing I need to do is move away from the other hand, which is going to have just as much ambition to come towards me, okay? I put the power in the front, so I establish my power in the front. I'm traditionally an orthodox striker. I'm not a southpaw, okay? So, when I do this power position, when I come into the position, I advance on him, okay? This puts all my power in the front. Much like how Bruce Lee always liked to fight as a southpaw, put all the power in the front, and then implemented speed. We do this, but then we close the distance as a part of our style. So, he's coming in, he's very aggressive in this. What I need to do is, he's gonna wanna hit me with this. I need to take this away first and foremost. Okay, so I'm coming in and finding a safe spot, much like closing the distance last time, but I'm gonna trap again, and I'm going to either, if he had no jacket, reach to his shoulder, and establish some distance, especially away. If he wants to headbutt me when I squeeze here, he can't hit it. If I was holding out here and he wanted to headbutt, he's gonna connect. So when I reach in for a high collar grip, I create distance, but not too much. Okay? From this power position, which has actually been modified from traditional judo, if we were in judo here, I would be grabbing his lapel, getting inside here, and working to off-balance him in different directions. The power position understands that we're not in registered competition. He's going to use this hand to strike me. This takes a lot of time to release and come up. It's going to be effective. But if I'm here, and this hand comes over, I'm inside with him. If it comes under, I pull him through. And if he uses his legs to knee, I move. Or if he's advancing or trying to come away, okay, if he's going to try and pull back on me, I can release and put him down. Very fluid, just basic movements. Okay? So then I can use what's inner repo, uchigari. I have a lot of options here. The biggest one is that my position is neither too low like a wrestler, not too upright like a boxer, but finding that happy medium in between, okay? From this happy medium, you can execute techniques. Coming back to our side sweeping break fall, maintaining this position. I have to break his balance first. I have to offset him, okay? So I offset by bringing his elbow in. From here, again, into my core basic techniques, the sumo stance, shikodachi, extending the leg, sitting down, okay? And finishing always in the mount. This is a very dominant position. The fact that this is the most dominant position is that I can reach him, but he can't reach me. But when he tries to reach me, he gives me the opportunity to manipulate the limbs, either through joint locks or submission. So, as we break down and bring all the basic elements together, we are going to put them together into a kata routine, okay? So, we're going to use the basic elements of closing the distance, moving this jab cross, okay? Switch feet, please. Doesn't matter. This is a better.
Yep.
Here. One. Okay. Pushing parry. Coming across. Advancing in. Much like TIE fighters will slip and put the knee. Okay? So we come in close, hit with the knee. Still advancing, because if I stay beside him, we have the same foundation. There's no way to break this foundation. When I advance, okay, push, I then own his balance. Breaking balance of Kazushi. From here, I can attack. Still maintaining position the whole time. I go for a traditional knee on belly, or we like to roll them in the floating rib. A lot of police personnel use this pin on the floating rib in sport Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. You see a lot of the knee on bellies. But maintaining this position and my hands still knowing this is active, this is active. And coming up, traditional figure four, bridging across the knuckles, into the sternum, posture, submit. This is a second of a 15 series kata in which we break down all elements. Okay? So, again, from here, he's going to come in, parry, push, strike, still moving. Breaking of the balance, putting him down, and then wrapping this right up. Sternum, posture, submission. Thank you, sir. All right, so just come back around. And come here. Again, always closing the distance. Position control. He's in here. Power position. Waiting is not an option. And you need to be first. Meet the attack. Come to it. Send, no send. Okay? You're keeping a partner safe and yourself. And that's the core aspect of martial arts.
I'm really impressed with this particular system. I mean, it's, I think for me, I've always been partial to the older styles, and part of that reason, I didn't want to diminish what the modern styles do,
yeah.
But part of the reason is the courtesy that you pay to mm-hmm. your opponent, your partner, that oftentimes seems lacked in the more modern styles. And one thing I really like, not only the technique's effective, you also have the courtesy, the respect for one another. And the techniques seem very effective. So
thank you very much.
Yeah, so thank you very much for coming. It was just tremendous. It was tremendous.
Thank you very much.
Very effective techniques.
Thank you.
Thank you. And thank you very much for watching this episode of Secrets of Martial Arts.
A lot better than last week.